So this is day three, starting the finish coat, and half of the cement fell off the chimney. I started picking at a crack, and I'm glad I did, because the majority of the thin that was there has fallen off. The rest is adhered very tight to the brick, so I'm just gonna do a very quick, rough, horrible finish coat, let it dry, and then start improving upon that probably tomorrow, because it's going to be too thick to dry today to do a second coat. And yes, I could mix up base mortar and do it again in that big hole in the middle, but I'm not going to. It's a small hole, and I'm going to try and not do it, just put several coats of the thin finish coat. Over the years, I have always mixed by hand so that I can check the consistency, I think, is my excuse. I always mix about half a bag at a time, because if I mix more, it cures before I finish. Over the years, I've now turned finally to using one of these things. That's a quick, is the reason I prefer it. Too wet, it only takes a tiny amount of powder to go from too wet to too hard. off a little bit, or let him go. Nice big scoop. Too wet. Ah, driving me a little nuts. That is perfect for a final coat, but I am not at that stage. I am still building up nasty places. So a little while just to get the really bad spots built up, such as the edges. Care about a few lumps, because after this coat I will knock it down with the sander and then do one final coat. Smooth. you just keep doing a lot of that. I'm declaring a victory in that this one room base of the finished plaster is finished. The walls are now straight is really all I can say. That chimney breast took three coats. That end wall took two. This end wall, this side wall here, has taken two. And that end wall over there and that one are not too bad, but they will also take two to get them straight. Once they're straight, I can then knock off the lumps with a sharp trowel and do a final beautiful skim, which I will tape another day when we're doing an update for some other reason, because plastering, I am done with plastering. We've also today put more windows in, but that's subject to a different video. This room used to feel like a dungeon. Now it feels like a room, so I'm quite happy with that. This 90-minute mud that I use, I still have absolutely no idea what the 90 minutes is supposed to stand for. When you mix it, it is usable for about 20 minutes before it starts to cure. So it's not the cure time. Once it's on the wall and you leave it alone, it takes at least 5 or 6 hours in good conditions to dry sufficient to sand it. Maybe it means that after an hour and a half, you can put a second coat over the top, but you can't if what you had to do was fairly thick. 90 minutes doesn't stand for that either. But it's good stuff. It's extremely sticky. You would have noticed that this wall was pretty rough and pretty dirty and had even some loose stuff that I was knocking off as I was plastering. And this stuff is good for that. It sticks to anything. And that's why I use it. So enough for the finish coat plastering. And I'm gonna tidy up and head out for a day. This has taken 10 bags of plaster and has taken 4 days. Not full days, but 4 part days. I'd say it would have taken 3 full days.